Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to see distillation, that is continuous distillation. It is also called as fractionator. Myself, Ashwini Patil from MVP's KBT College of Engineering, Nashik, Department of Instrumentation and Control. So fractionator or continuous distillation, we can say. Now, basically, this is a distillation column. All of you know what is distillation process. In evaporation, the liquid which we want to concentrate, we just evaporate it. That means we vaporize the liquid part of it. In fractionate, in distillation, that vapors which are formed, we again cool it and convert it into liquid. And that is how we different we separate out the one component of the liquid mixture from the liquid mixture. Now, fractionating column, it is a distillation. A continuous distillation, specifically we are going to see in this session this continuous distillation or fractionating column. This is a very useful distillation, costly, but in case of whenever we need 98% of pure product, about 98% in petroleum industries or in mines, so in such cases this fractionating column, it most of the time it is used. Now in this session we are going to see the working, and in next session we are going to see how the mathematic modeling of it is done. Now here, this is a distillation column, and this distillation column, in this distillation column there are different trays which are placed. These trays are either placed in alternating fashion such way, or all these trays are perforated. Exactly at mid of this column there is a feed feed plate, where the feed is taken inside. Most of the time this feed is preheated or even partially vaporized. That means it is boiled at the boiling temperature of the more volatile component, and then it is taken inside here. So in this distillation column, the main components are: at bottom there is a reboiler, at top there is a condenser. And the very important and part of this distillation column fractionator is this reflux pump, or this reflux which is taken or recycled at the top of the distillation column. And basically this reflux, which is used here for more pure product, it make a difference in fractionating column. Now this distillation column is divided into two parts. One, that above top half part is called as rectifying section, and bottom half part is called as stripping section. We'll see why these are called as rectifying and stripping section. And exactly at mid of the column there is a feed plate, where feed is distributed or feed is taken inside. This is a bottom plate, and here there is a top plate. Now the working of this distillation column, we'll see. Feed is fitted exactly at mid, which is preheated, or it is at a partial vaporized condition. When it is taken inside, so it will fall down, and again here it is recycled or reheated through this reboiler and taken inside the distillation column. Now vapors which are formed here, it will pass upward. At every plate, these vapors will come in intimate contact with each other with this feed which is fitted. That means this feed will flow downward, these vapors will flow upward, and at every plate, this feed liquid and these vapors, it will come in contact with each other. And here the equilibrium which is attained, which is the most important part, that at every tray the equilibrium is attained, because when equilibrium is attained, only then the efficiency of this distillation column, it will reach up to the mark. Now, and even the pure product, that purity which I said just now, that 98% about a purified product we get. So due to this equilibrium which is attained at every plate, due to that only this purification will take place. Now as this feed which may be partially vaporized or which may be preheated, when it will come in contact with these vapors, so the more volatile components of these more volatile component which is to be separated of this feed. So it will be vaporized. So at every stage, due to the heat of the vapors which are passing upward, which will become in intimate contact with each at each plate. So due to this temperature of vapors, the more volatile component of this feed, it will vaporize, and more it will go upward. More and more this vapor will be richer with the more volatile component. Now above this feed plate in rectifying section, what will happen, that we'll see. Now these vapors which will pass upward, these vapors will be passed through the condenser here, and in these condensers, those condenser, that vapor, it is liquefied, that means it is condensed, it is converted into the liquid form, and some of the product which is taken and little part of it is taken as a reflux and which is recycled at the top plate of the distillation column. Now this reflux, it is again equally distributed at top place. Now this liquid, which is a liquid, which is its temperature is less as compared to the vapors which are passing upward in the rectifying section. So in rectifying section, what happens is this reflux liquid, which is passing downward, it will be in intimate contact with the vapors which are passing upward. So when these vapors which are coming upward, so little bit less volatile component of the feed will be there in these vapors, because with the more volatile component, some part of the less volatile component which is unwanted at as a product at top, so it will be again convert into the reflux. So we can see here, suppose here there is a reflux will be there, the vapors which are passing upward. So suppose at this plate, these vapors and this reflux liquid, it will be in intimate contact with each other. So the equilibrium will be attained. So equilibrium stage is nothing but it's a saturated condition. That means maximum exchange. Beyond that, there is no conversion is possible. That is the equilibrium condition. So whatever the low volatile component of the vapor, it will be in contact with this liquid, so it will again convert into liquid part. So as it will pass downward at every plate, it will happen that the less volatile component, which is the unwanted part in this vapors, which will be liquefied and it will pass downward. And then what will happen at top, when this vapor will pass in the condenser, it will be more purified, high volatile component. And so again the same thing will be repeated at every continuously. That overhead product, it is nothing but it's a output, it will be taken out, and some part of it will be recycled through the reflux pump at the top plate of the distillation column. So this is what is the fractionating column or distillation column. Just we'll go through the next slide. So once again, I will revise it. Components of fractionator: column with reboiler. So this is a column with perforated plates which are mounted in the column, with reboiler at bottom and with condenser at top. The reflux pump, which function of which is to recycle the some part of this product at the top of the column, and it is run back to a drum from which it is pumped to the top of the column. So here it is pumped into the top of the column. So top product is divided into final product and the reflux. Here this is a top product, it is a overhead product, means final product, which is the output, and very small part of it is taken as a reflux here. The column, which is divided into two sections, that is a rectifying section and here is a stripping section. Now why it is called as a stripping section and this is called as rectifying section? Stripping is nothing but it's an operation in which the more volatile component of this feed, which is vaporized due to the heat of the vapors which are passing upward. That means the more volatile component of this feed, it will be stripped off, and that's why it is called as a stripping section. And in rectifying section, so basically the less volatile component which is unwanted in these vapors, again it will be converted into liquid and it will be passed downward when it will come in contact with the reflux. And so it is called as rectifying section because it rectifies the less volatile component from the vapor. So it is called as rectifying section. So liquid reflux flows downwards and vapor upward across each tray and attain equilibrium in rectifying section. So equilibrium means nothing but it is a saturation stage or further conversion is not possible that stage. Feed flows downward and vapor upward across each tray and attain equilibrium across each tray in the stripping section. So on each tray, some of the less volatile component condenses from rising vapors into the liquid and thus increasing the concentration of more volatile component in the vapor in this rectifying section. And some of the more volatile component is vaporized from the liquid on tray and thus decreasing the concentration of more volatile component in the liquid. So just now whatever we had discussed in stripping and rectifying section, the same thing it is. So basically one very important thing is how much this reflux should be. So basically if reflux, quantity of reflux will be more. So what will happen? If the quantity of reflux will be more, then in that case, the purity of this product will obviously increase. But the efficiency will decrease because whatever product we have taken, we are recycling it here. And again, it is passing through this column. So again, the heat energy, it is utilized for its conversion again. So more the reflux will be, more the purity will be, but less the efficiency will be. And vice versa, if the reflux will be less, so in that case the efficiency will be more, but it may hamper the purity of the product. So as per the requirement, the reflux flow which is decided. This is how the fractionating column works. Hope you have understood. Thank you.